You know, I had to explain to a victim's family why they've got a guilty verdict one minute and not guilty the next.
Thursday, a jury found this little boy's daycare provider guilty of child endangerment. But moments later, the judge overturned that verdict, citing insufficient evidence. Tonight's big story, family members and prosecutors' disappointment. Good evening, I'm Julie Cornell.
I'm Rob McCartney. Prosecutors questioned the judge's timing, saying he had two opportunities to rule on evidence before the case went to the jury. Tonight's big story, the roller coaster of emotions for the little boy's family and what prosecutors plan to do next. KATV News Watch 7's Brandi Peterson joins us live from the Pottawatomie County Courthouse. Brandi?
Well, Rob and Julie, the two-year-old's parents tell me his injuries were so serious he was near death. They say they are shocked and devastated about the judge's decision. Jay Newman just turned two on Saturday. The last few months have been tough for him and his parents, Molly and Michael.
Show me your tummy!
An 8-inch scar is a reminder of his emergency surgery in June because of an abdominal injury.
I walked in and he was laying on the couch and he was pale white. His lips were purple.
Jay's daycare provider was arrested and charged with neglect or abandonment and child endangerment with serious injury. Last week, the case went to trial. A jury found the woman not guilty on two counts, but guilty for the count of child endangerment described as willingly depriving a child of necessary health care appropriate to the child's age.
The judge dismissed the jury, said thank you for your service, and then about a minute later came back in, set aside the jury's verdict, and entered judgment of acquittal or not guilty.
In his order, Judge Timothy O'Grady said the evidence is not sufficient to sustain a conviction that defendant acted intentionally or by fixed design or purpose and not accidentally to deny Jay Newman necessary health care or supervision appropriate to his age. Pottawatomie County Attorney Matt Wilbur.
I can't ethically take a case to trial that I don't believe we have enough evidence. So, I mean, obviously, just the fact that we took it tells you that, you know, we believed we had enough. Obviously, so did the police officers, so did the doctors, and ultimately, so did the jury.
Wilbur says he feels bad for the 12 jurors who deliberated for 10 hours on the case and for the victim's family.
We don't understand how this could have happened through the court system. I mean, someone needs to be accountable for their actions, for what happened to Jay. I want to explain to him that we did everything we could to get him justice, to get justice for our little boy.
And we were not able to reach Judge O'Grady this afternoon for comment.
And Brandi, then what happens now?
Well, Matt Wilbur has contacted the Iowa Attorney General about a possible appeal. Bob Brammer, a spokesperson for the office, says, quote, we will consult with the county attorney and consider whether to appeal the judge's decision.
All right, Brandi Peterson, live in California.